Good morning, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姐妹们，早安。
Thank the Lord that we can come before Him again this morning.
我们实在感谢我们的主，再一次我们能够一起到他面前来。
It is always a privilege to share His word with you.
我们何等荣幸能够在这里分享他的话语。
Let us come before Him in prayer.
让我们现在把时间交在他的手中。
Our gracious Heavenly Father.
我们慈悲仁爱的天父。
We thank you for the privilege of speaking for you, Lord.
我们感谢你赐给我们这样的恩典，能够来为你说话。
Please grant us grace for Brother Michael and myself to speak for you this morning.
请你赐给我跟 Michael 弟兄的恩典，让我们今早能够做你的出口。
And we claim your promise, Lord, that your word goes out and not return empty-handed.
我们要抓住你的应许，你曾说你的话从口中出去就不空空的回归。
And serve the purpose you intended for.
乃是成就你所定义的。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉主耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.Well, this year 2023 is still at an early stage.
在2023年还是我们的早期的时候。
But time moves so quickly, for January is already behind us.
但时间过得实在很快，因为一月份已经过去了。
I heard it said that the older you get, the faster it goes.
曾经听人说，你越年老，时间过得越快。
I can relate to these words.
我自己能够感受到这一点是真的。
How has the year been for you so far?
我要问问你，这一年你现在的情形怎样？
Hopefully some of you have come across some joyful events.
盼望你们也曾经经历了喜悦的时刻。
And some of you have already encountered difficulties.
或者你们当中也有人经历了难处。
Whatever they are, we move ahead by the grace of God.
但无论怎样，靠神的恩典，我们都能够继续向前去。
In the first few days of 2023, I came across a very tragic story.
在2023年开始的时候，我就听见了一个很悲惨的事情。
It happened on Wednesday, the 4th of January.
乃是在一月四号星期三的那一天发生的。
I was to return to work on the 9th of January.
本来我是在一月九号才回去工作的。
I went on the 4th of January to the office to get things, a few things prepared.
所以，但是在四号那一天，我就先回到我的公司那里去做一些预备的工作。
As we were still closed, I wasn't expecting the phone to ring.
因为那个时候我们的公司还在关闭的状态，还停业的状态，所以我没有想到我的电话会响。
The phone rang, so I picked up the call.
所以公司电话响了，我就接了这个电话。
It was a young woman's voice, and she said she needed some printing urgently.
我听见是一个年轻的女孩子的声音，她说她们紧急的需要我们帮她们印一些单张。
She said she needed some booklets for her daughter's funeral.
她这个女人就告诉我说，请我能够帮她印她女儿葬礼的一些这个上面的节目单。
Her voice started to tremble.
我一听见她的声音就已经好像很伤心的。
Up to this moment, I had never spoken to her before.
因为在那一刻之前，我从来没有跟这个人说过任何话。
Officially, we were still closed.
而且我们那个时候已经公司还在停业的状况。
But I sensed her need, and I said I would do it for her.
但是我能够听见她是很紧急的需要，而我也愿意帮助她。
When I received the file, I was deeply saddened.
等我接到了她送给我这个文件的时候，我实在非常的伤心。
Her daughter had died. She was only 21 months old.
她的女儿去世了，才21个月。
Reading the order of service, I could see they're Christians.
当我们看见她这个里面的节目的安排的时候，那一天的安排的次序的安排的时候，我可以想象她是一个基督徒。
Several questions came into my mind straight away.
但是当我看的时候，我思想中有了一些的问题。
Why?
为什么会这样
？How?
而且是怎样发生的
？When?
是什么时候发生的
？What were the circumstances？
到底是在什么情形之下发生的
？Knowing her emotional state, I did not ask her the questions.
但因为听见她那个时候很忧伤，所以我没有提出这些问题。
Two days later, her sister-in-law came to pick up the booklets.
两天之后，她的一个姐姐或者妹妹就来拿这些印好的资料。
I asked her the questions that were on my mind.
之后我思想中这些问题我就问出来了。
The child died in a sleep between the night of Christmas and Boxing Day.
Christmas and Boxing Day. 他说这个孩子是在夜间圣诞节的晚上跟那一天这个拆礼物的那一天早晨上去世的。
On Christmas Day, they had a wonderful time opening presents.
在这个圣诞节的时候，他们一家人都很开心，在那里打开这些啊礼物。
The family had a joyful time.
整一家人都非常的快乐。
As usual, the mother put her child to sleep at night.
所以等到晚上的时候，母亲就把孩子送到房间里去睡觉。
When the mother went to get up in the morning, she had died.
但是等到早晨又去把这个孩子叫起来的时候，发现自己的孩子已经去世了。
She died in her sleep.
这孩子在睡觉之中去世的。
Can you imagine the shock the mother would have received?
你可以想象那一刻母亲何等伤痛的心吗？
Through the autopsy, they could not find the cause of death.
但之后他们验尸之后也不能够找出这个孩子去世的原因。
I cannot even imagine the mental and emotional state of the young parents.
我实在很难想象这个年轻这对夫妇他们思想跟那个精神上所受的打击何等的大。
Most of you will remember the Bali bombing of 20 years ago.
你们可能也有其中有些人能记得二十年前在巴厘岛上啊这个爆炸的事情。
At the time, our children were still in school.
在那个时候，我自己的孩子他们还在读书。
And one of the teachers lost his son in the bombing.
其中我孩子读书那个学校的一个老师，他的一个儿子就在那一次巴厘岛的爆炸事件中去世了。
I remember speaking to the teacher, and this is what he told me.
当我记得跟那个老师说话的谈话的时候，他是这样对我说的。
He said, "I expect parents to die before their children."
他说我一直都以为做父母的一定会死在孩子之前。
He never expected his son to die before him.
他从来没有想过他的儿子会在他之前去世。
Sometimes we can ask all the questions that we have.
有时候我们可以提出许许多多的问题。
And sometimes we just don't have the answers.
但是我们却得不到答案。
All the Bible knowledge that we have are put to the ultimate test.
当这事情发生的时候，我们所学习这些圣经的知识好像才真正的得到试验。
The ultimate test of intellectual knowledge and living out this knowledge.
就是这个思想中的、头脑中的知识和活出来的经历。
We say we trust God, and God is saying, "Now you show me."
我们说我们信靠神，那神说，在这样的时刻，你能信靠我吗？
To accept that God is God.
你真的认识神是神吗？
He is in the heavens, and He does as He pleases.
因为神在天上，他按着自己所喜悦去行事。
As I shared before, we can ask God all the questions we want, but we cannot demand an answer.
就是我以前说过的，我们可以向神提出许许多多的问题，但是回不回答我们问题是在乎神。
I pray for this family.
我为这个女儿去世这个家庭祷告。
For God to sustain and uphold them.
求神能够保护他们，支持他们。
To comfort them in a way that only He can.
是按着神的方法来安慰他们。
A truly tragic story.
我心里实在是很忧伤。
A tragedy, but from the order of service, I could see the parents have hope.
但是在这个这个葬礼的安排上面，我看见他们的父母心中还有盼望。
They have hope because of Jesus Christ.
他们有盼望，因为他们相信主耶稣基督。
One of the hymns they selected was "It Is Well with My Soul."
而他们所选的一首诗歌，又唱的诗歌就是《我的魂啊，可安息》。
With this sad story, it gives us a glimpse of how this family can move forward.
因此，这样的一首诗歌，我们知道他这个家庭还能够继续的向前去。
There is only one way.
他们只有一条路。
It is only possible by the grace of God.
这条路是可能的，是靠神的恩典才成为可能。
I'm sure tears will follow in the months ahead.
我们知道这其中许许多多的眼泪都会流下来。
Even into the years.
或者之后的许多年。
It is a memory that will never forget for the rest of their lives.
因为这是他们一生所不能忘记所发生的一件事情。
Even Jesus wept.
因为耶稣也曾经哭了。
Grief and mourning is part of what we are.
作为人，我们会忧伤，我们会心痛。
But Christians mourn with hope.
但我们作为基督徒，我们可以忧伤，但我们也有盼望。
This morning sharing is about God's grace.
今天早上的分享的信息是关乎神的恩典。
It comes in many forms.
神的恩典很许多方面向我们显明。
More forms that we can ever appreciate or number.
乃是我们数都数不过来的。
As Christians, each believer is the recipient of God's grace.
作为一个基督徒，每一个基督徒都是接受神恩典的器皿。
The most foundational doctrine of the true Christian faith.
而真正基督教的信仰的根基就是
Every other faith or world religion will find how to earn their favor from God.
跟其他世界上其他宗教所不一样的地方，因为其他的宗教都是说你怎么样的去行善、去积德、去尽你正定的能力去得着。
They will chant and they will wear religious robes.
他们有很多啊，这些宗教的仪式和修养逼着你去做。
They will live a life of celibacy and they burn incense.
他们又很多的刻苦己心，他们又这样烧香献祭。
They will endeavor to obey a long list of do's and don'ts.
他们好像又守住很多可做不可做的事情。
The true Christian faith is salvation by grace, by Christ, in Christ.
但是基督徒的得救的福音就是一切都是恩典。
The unmerited favor of God through His Son.
乃是神借着他儿子所赐给我们的恩典。
Brothers and sisters, this is only the beginning.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，这只是一个开始。
The grace of God never stops.
因为神的恩典从来没有停止过。
The Apostle Paul puts it, Peter puts it this way.
彼得曾经，使徒彼得曾经这样说。
May God give you more and more grace and peace.
愿神把恩惠平安多多的加给你们。
Being recipients of God's grace, how do we live out this grace?
既然我们接受了神的恩典，那我们怎么样才能够活出这个恩典呢？
What do we do with this priceless gift of grace?
这么宝贵的恩典赐给我们，我们应该怎么样回应？
Why did God give us grace?
为什么神要把恩典赐给我们？
With God's help, I hope to answer these questions.
靠着神，我盼望能够给一个答案。
Truth be told, it will take more than a lifetime to talk about God's grace.
真实的说，是靠需要我们一生才能够去完全的讲透神的恩典。
I will only touch on a few aspects.
那我只是略略从几个方面来讲。
We start with the grace of hope.
第一，我们要看恩典中的盼望。
The parents of this little child live with the grace of hope.
这个去世的女儿的这位父母，他们因为有盼望，所以能够活下去。
It sounds strange to say something like this.
你听起来说有点怪。
They have just lost their daughter, who's not even 2 years old.
他们刚刚失去了自己的一个女儿，还不到两岁的女儿。
I say this because they are Christians.
我能够这样说，因为他们是基督徒。
The person I met was a sister-in-law.
虽然我遇见的是那个妻子的姐姐或者妹妹。
The family acknowledged that this little girl is in a much better place.
因为这个家人都承认，这个孩子现今已经在更好的一个地方。
Is it a hope that has no foundation?
他们的盼望是没有根基的盼望吗？
Is it wishful thinking to make themselves feel better?
他们这样的说法只是一种心理的安慰吗？
Their hope is because they know that their little girl is in the Lord's presence.
他们能够这样说有盼望，因为他们知道他们的孩子已经在神的面前。
How do they know that?
他们怎么知道呢？
We go back to the Word of God.
我们在神的圣经里面找到。
The Bible does not explicitly answer whether babies go to heaven or not.
虽然圣经没有很清楚地说到孩子死后去哪里。
But we can use Bible passages to piece together to give a satisfactory answer.
但是我们从圣经里面的记载，我们可以知道这个他所说的真正的内容。
I will use two passages.
我又引用两处的圣经。
They know the truth about God because he has made it obvious to them. For ever since the world was created,People have seen the earth and sky. Through everything God made, they can clearly see His invisible qualities, His eternal power and divine nature, so they have no excuse for not knowing God.
神的事情，人所能知道的，原显明在人心里，因为神已经给他们显明。自从造天地以来，神的永能和神性是明明可知的，虽是眼不能见， 但借着所造之物就可以晓得，叫人无可推诿。
Adults have no excuse for not knowing God.
成年人没有任何的借口可以说没有神。
They have seen God's creation.
因为他们亲眼看见神的创造。
The creation of man and woman.
神创造了男人女人。
They see the sun, the moon, and the stars.
他们看见太阳、月亮、星星。
They breathe the air each day.
他们每一天都在呼吸着神所造的空气。
But in their pride, they reject God's son.
但是因人心里的骄傲，他们拒绝了神。
Whom he has sent to die for their sins.
他们拒绝了神所差遣来为他们罪而死的耶稣。
They reject Christ because they want to live life their way.
他们拒绝耶稣，因为他们想活自己，让自己的方法来活。
Infants and young children don't have the capacity to understand God's creation.
但是一个婴儿小孩，他们没有这个能力来理解神这一切的创造。
Nor do they have the capacity to understand between right and wrong.
他们也没有这个能力能够知道什么是对，什么是错。
Our God is a just and merciful God.
但是我们的神是一位公义和怜悯的神。
And this is consistent with God's character.
而这是神自己的神性。
Of justice, love, and mercy.
他是公义的，他是爱的，他是怜悯的。
The second passage.
第二处的圣经。
But now he has died. Why should I fast? Can I bring him back again? I'm going to him.But he will not return to me.
孩子死了，我何必禁食？我岂能使他返回呢？我必往他那里去，他却不能回到我这里来。
This verse comes from the passage where the son of the adulterous affair between David and Bathsheba was born.
这一处圣经是发生在以色列王大卫和别色巴之间啊，犯罪之后所怀有的孩子。
As punishment to David.He took away the son.
神对大卫的审判就使得孩子死了。
The child born of this affair did not commit a sin.
但是这出生的孩子还没有犯过一件的罪。
When Nathan confronted David, immediately David said, I have sinned against the Lord.
等这个拿单到大卫先知拿单到大卫面大卫王面前的时候一提出来大卫就认罪说我有罪了。
David's deep contrite heart when we read from Psalm 32 and 51.
我们在诗篇32篇51篇读到大卫的心是何等忧伤痛悔。
You could see his repentance there.
我们看见大卫在那里悔改。
David believed in God and his destiny was heaven.
因为大卫他信靠神所以他知道他自己又去天堂。
His destiny is because of Genesis 15:6.
他能够这样清楚知道乃是就是啊，创世纪15:6
Abraham believed the Lord, and the Lord credited as righteousness to him.
因为亚伯拉罕信神，神就称他为义。
David clearly expected that his son would join him one day.
所以大卫非常相信有一天他孩子又跟他在一起。
Our baby is born with original sin.
我们的孩子出生是有人。的罪
Most certainly.
当然他们生下来就有罪性。
But a baby and very young child has not reached the age of accountability.
但是作为一个孩子他们 还没有成长到一个可以负起责任 的时候。
What time would that be?
那能负责任的时候是什么时候呢
I'll leave that in the hands of our sovereign God.
我们把这样的时间归在我们神的手中。
But the Bible clearly teaches Godcares and deeply loves children.
那圣经又教导我们，神是何等的爱我们的孩子。
But Jesus said, "Leave the children alone and do not forbid them to come to me, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these."
耶稣说：“让小孩子到我这里来，不要禁止他们，因为在天国了，正是这样的人。”
Even though they don't specifically say, but they collectively show that of God's character, justice, love, and mercy.
所以从这几处的圣经我们看见神的神性他是 慈爱的他是怜悯的。
But we can be sure his judgment is always right.
他也是公义的他的审判都是对的。
His character is flawless. Flawless.、
哦、他神的性格乃是没有任何出错的地方。
And his mercy is deep.
而他的怜悯是深厚的。
And of course his love.
还有他的爱。
And his desires for people to be saved.
而神乃是愿意人人得救。
The grace of hope is found in many, many issues of life.
神的恩典能够临到我们生活中的每一个角落。
Through life disappointments and the brokenness of life in this world.
或者在我们生活中遇见的失望，遇见的一些破碎的事情。
We seek the Lord's grace to help us to cope.
我们好像失去了任何的能力来面对发生在我们身上的事情。
I never lose hope.
但是我们永远不会失去盼望。
The Lord has a way to deal with our instinct of self-dependency.
主有他的方法能够来对付我们靠自己的这个想法。
As if he finds us, he's actually teaching us to depend on him.
好像他一直在教导我们怎样能够不靠自己而依靠他。
Not just when things are going well.
不只是当一切都很顺利。
But in times of adversity and extreme testing.
乃是遇见极大的难处和越不过去的难大的事情的时候。
The grace of hope is in all aspects of a Christian life.
盼望的恩典是临到我们生活中的每一点每一滴。
But the epitome of this hope is in our Lord's return.
但是我们看见最终的这个盼望就是神我们的主耶稣的再来。
And they speak of how you are looking forward to the coming of God's Son from heaven, Jesus, whom God raised from the dead. He is the one who has rescued us from the terrors of the coming judgment.
等候他儿子，就是神的儿子耶稣基督从天降临，就是他从死里复活的那位救我们脱离将来愤怒的耶稣。
Until the Lord's return, adversities of life will continue.
直到我们的主的回来，我们在生活中还是会遇见许多的困难。
Christians always have hope because of Christ.
当基督徒有盼望，因为我们有耶稣。
Those who reject Christ will face the terrors of the coming judgment.
而凡拒绝基督、耶稣基督的，他们都要面对将要临到他们身上永远的审判。
The terrors will be beyond your every imagination.
是审判的可怕之处，是乃至越过我们所思所想的。
I move to our next grace.
我们现在又看我们的第二点。
The grace to forgive and love.
就是能够去使我们能够去爱、去赦免的恩典。
There's something that we all have in common.
我们都有共同的一点。
Each one where wrong has been done to us.
当别人错误地对待我们。
And we have done wrong to others.
或者我们错误地对待别人。
When we have done wrong, we seek forgiveness from God.
当我们做错得罪神的时候，我们求神赦免我们。
We should also apologize to the person we've done wrong to.
当我们做对别人做的不对的地方，我们也求别人的原谅。
Yes, it takes humility, but it's the right thing to do.
实在需要我们谦卑下来，但这是对的事情。
The more difficult thing is when the wrong has been done to us.
更难做的乃是当别人得罪你。
It is more difficult because we have no control over the other person.
人得罪了你，因为我们也没有能力去控制别人该怎么去做。
And the wrong done to us could be severe.
有时候他们对我们做的事情会非常非常的不好。
And the wrong done to you could be over a long time.
或者他对你所做的事情可能影响你的一生。
The wrong has caused you deep hurt.
而所做的事情带来极大的伤害。
And you simply cannot forgive.
你心里面实在的不能够原谅他们。
Please do not understand what I'm about to say.
请你不要误会我将要说的事情。
I am not underplaying the hurt that you have suffered.
我这里不是说在看低你所受的痛苦。
You may think it is easy for me to say because I'm not the one who suffered your hurt.
你觉得你说的容易，因为受得罪的不是你。
I'm sharing this is because how the Lord has taught me.
我能够这样说，是因为主教导了我。
He has taught me He is my best healer.
他教导我，主是我最好的医治者。
Why do I say this?
那我为什么这样说呢？
Because he healed the most important relationship in my life.
因为他医治了我人生中最重要的一个关系。
Our Lord Jesus healed my relationship with my Lord Jesus Christ.
我们的主耶稣医治了我跟他和神的关系。
He reconciled me to my Heavenly Father.
他使我天上的父亲和好。
Through this reconciliation, my Lord Jesus saved me from hell.
而因着他使我与神和好，他拯救我脱离了地狱。
He did it out of His grace, love, and mercy.
他是充满着恩典，充满着爱和怜悯来拯救我。
To me, a wretched sinner from the moment I was conceived.
我作为一个从出生就是生在罪里的人。
Because I've tasted His love, grace, and mercy, I am able to forgive and love.
因为我尝了主所给我的恩典和他的爱和怜悯，所以我能够赦免和原谅。
No matter what wrong has been done towards me.
无论人怎样的得罪了我们。
Why am I able to do this?
那为什么我们能够原谅他们呢？
Because the focus is not on my hurt.
因为我所注重的不是我受到的伤害。
The focus is on Lord Jesus Christ.
我所注视的乃是我们的主耶稣。
I remember what He has done for me.
因为我记起了耶稣为我所做的一切。
I remember His agonizing time in the Garden of Gethsemane.
我能够记起他在客西马尼所受的痛苦。
I remember His humiliation.
我知道他受了何等大的羞辱。
I remember how His disciples deserted Him.
我也能够记起他的门徒怎样的抛弃了他。
I remember how our Lord described His soul was crushed.
我看见主是何等的受压太重。
And I remember how He suffered on the cross.
我也能够记起主在十字架上所受的苦痛。
Through all this suffering, and yet He could say,
当他受了这一切的苦难，却能够说这样的话。
Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing.
当下耶稣说，父啊，赦免他们，因为他们所做的，他们不晓得。
Our ability to forgive and love is not out of determination or willpower.
我们能够原谅赦免别人，不是出于我们自己的意志力
，or our self-righteousness, or we think that we have a big heart,
或者因为我们的自义，觉得我们的心很大。
Sure, you can try to do that.
可能你尝试这样去做。
You can try to bury it deep inside your heart.
你或者把你所受的痛苦深深的藏在心里
，lock it inside a hidden chamber.
或者把它给锁起来。
The problem with that is somewhere along the line.This will surface again.
但这个问题说在你人生中有一个时刻，它可能就会爆发出来。
Because you have not really forgiven the wrong done to you.
因为你没有真正的从心里赦免那得罪你的人。
My ability to forgive and love is by God's grace.
我们是靠着神的恩典，我们才有能力去原谅、饶恕别人。
How do I do that?
我们怎样去行呢？
Because I've channeled it.To the Lord.
因为我们把这一切都交到主的手中。
Imagine it's like a river that flows to the Lord.
就如像一条河一样的，这些都流向了主那里。
You hand your hurt to Him.
你把你所受的痛苦交托给他。
Don't cling on to the hurt.
不要紧紧地抓住你所受的痛苦。
It is a very natural thing to do.
这是我们人很自然会做的事情。
Clinging on to your hurt brings baggage to your spiritual life.
你如果紧紧抓住你所受的痛苦，你就把重担压在你自己的灵魂上。
Due to hidden unforgiveness, you will bring it up at some point in your life.
因为你没有从心里的赦免，在你人生总有一个时刻，它会重新的被揭露出来。
When you see an opportunity, this unforgiveness may become a weapon.
因为当你看见一个时刻、一个机会，你对这个人的不饶恕，就成为可以攻击他的一个机会。
Whether you are aware of it or not, when you do that, you are actually looking at self.
所以，无论你知不知道，你这样想、这样做的时候，你是因着自私。
You may think that you have forgiven, but you have not.
你思想觉得自己已经饶恕了这个人，但心还没有。
This is part of our fallen nature.
而这就是我们堕落的人性。
Spiritually speaking, you have not forgiven the wrong done against you.
属灵的来说，我们没有饶恕那得罪我们的人。
What is the effect of channeling your hurt to the Lord?
那怎么样才能够把我们所受的痛苦移到主那里去呢？
Basically, He is the one who is going to carry it for you.
因为变成主来为你担当你所受的重担。
He knows your hurt.
因为主知道你的痛苦。
He is the one who will truly heal you.
而且他有能力医治你。
By healing you, it will help you to learn how to forgive and to love the person who has done you this wrong.
而他医治的方法就帮助你怎么样去原谅、饶恕得罪你的人。
And you leave the baggage of unforgiveness behind.
你将一切你不能饶恕的重担都交到他那里去。
Most importantly, it will help you to love and forgive this person.
更重要的是，他的医治能够帮助你怎样去爱那得罪你的人。
Even though he or she has caused you much hurt.
无论是他是怎样使你受到何等大的伤害。
This is how Paul encourages us.
这是保罗这样的鼓励我们。
Since God chose you to be the holy people he loves, you must clothe yourself with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive others.
所以你们既是神的选民，圣洁蒙爱的人，就要存怜悯、恩慈、谦虚、温柔、忍耐的心。倘若这人与那人有嫌隙，总要彼此包容，彼此饶恕。主怎样饶恕了你们，你们也要怎样饶恕人。
To be able to clothe these attributes in life is a result of God's grace.
因为有神的恩典，我们才能够有这样的。我们这样的特点
and you are living out God's grace in your life.
你能够把神的恩典给活出来。
These attributes are very similar to the fruit of the Spirit in Galatians 5.
因为这里所提到的这些优点也跟加拉太书五章那里所提到的差不多。
Is it easy to wear this spiritual clothing?
我们把这样属灵的外衣披上来容易吗？
Well, it depends.
那又看你怎么样。
Depends on what?
你怎么样去对待呢？
It depends on how much you have died to self.
乃是在乎你的己是怎样的实际。
Is it possible?
可能做得到的吗？
Believe me, by God's grace, it is possible.
靠神的恩典，我们做得到。
It is possible because I have been through it.
我知道是可能的，因为我自己也曾经这样的经历。
The more we die to self, the more we want to obey God.
我们越能够实际，我们就越能够顺服神。
To forgive and to love are direct commandments from God.
我们能够去饶恕、去接纳别人，是神对我们的命令。
Please note the word must in the last sentence of this verse.
所以在英文里面是讲到你们必须饶恕他人。
This means forgiveness and love is not an option.
因为主说的话不是一个可能选择。
Our Lord commands and we obey.
乃是神的命令，我们必须遵守。
What happens when we don't forgive?
那如果我们不愿意饶恕别人，我们会变得怎样呢？
But if you refuse to forgive others, your Father will not forgive your sins.
你们若不饶恕人的过犯，你们的天父也必不饶恕你们的过犯。
This is a serious warning.
这是一个非常严肃的警告。
You will need to face our Lord one day.
因为有一天我们都要面对主。
Whatever reason you try to tell him that you could not forgive will not be sufficient.
你能想到了任何的借口理由说你为什么不能够饶恕人都靠不住。
Why?
为什么呢？
Because you have been disobedient.
因为你自己一直都不顺服。
Our fallen nature will try to justify our disobedience.
我们这个堕落的人性总是有找理由借口来开脱我们自己。
In God's economy, disobedience is disobedience.
但在神的眼中，不顺服就是不顺服。
You can tell the Lord, I was disobedient because of this or that.
你或者可以跟主找借口说，我不能够顺服你，因为这个原因，因为那个原因。
Brothers and sisters, disobedience is disobedience.
但弟兄姐妹，不顺服就是不顺服。
There is a strong warning about disobedience.
因为神对不顺服有一个非常重的警告。
If someone claims I know God but doesn't obey God's commandments, that person is a liar and is not living in the truth.
人若说我认识他，却是不遵守他的诫命，便是说谎话的，真理也不在他心里了。
If you cannot forgive and love, and if you are a Christian, God is saying you are a liar.
我们若不能够从心里饶恕别人的话而顺服神，那么神说你是一个说谎的人。
You may think to yourself, well, what about the person who has done me wrong?
你可能可以跟主说，那个得罪我的人怎么办？
You leave that to God.
你把那个人交在神的手里。
God exercises perfect justice in his time and in his will.
神是完全的公义，按着他的时间，按着他的方法来执行。
You need to come before the Lord to seek the grace to love and to forgive.
我们必须到神的面前寻求恩典，能够去饶恕别人。
To do what is right by him.
就是行眼神眼中看为对的事。
You are not responsible for the actions of the other person.
你不会为别人的行为负责。
But you are responsible for your actions.
当你就为自己的行为负责。
Perhaps you can meditate this verse in the days ahead.
或者在将来的日子，你能够花时间去默想这一节的经文。
In the end, it's all about release and submission.
因为最终的目的乃是要使我们得释放而顺服神。
Is it easy?
容易吗？
No, it's not easy.
当然不容易。
Is it impossible?
那是不可能的吗？
Definitely not.
当然是可能的。
Brothers and sisters, please remember one important thing.
弟兄姐妹，有一点我们必须记住的。
Our Lord does not ask us to do anything that He has not done already.
我们的主不会要求我们去做一件他自己没有做过的事。
It is natural for an unbeliever not to love and not to forgive.
一个不信耶稣的人不原谅、不饶恕人，这是正常的。
For a believer, this is not an option.
但是作为一个信徒，我们却没有其他的选择。
By God's grace, it is possible.
所以靠神的恩典，我们做得到。
We move to the next grace.
我们来看下一点。
The grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness.
我们能够向神，神使我们能够感恩的恩典。
Brothers and sisters, we know.We are very fortunate to live in this country.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们知道我们是很幸运能够活在这个国家。
When you've seen other countries, you will know what I mean.
你如果去看世界其他的地方，你就知道我说的是什么。
That there is no perfect to live in this world.
但在世界中没有一个完全的地方，完美的地方可以去居住。
Apostle Peter calls us temporary residents and foreigners in this world.
而使徒彼得说，我们乃是地上的客旅和过客。
As Christians, we're just passing by on our way to our eternal home.
我们作为基督徒，我们只是在经过这个世间，然后到我们永远的去处。
It doesn't where you live, we live in a fallen and broken world.
无论你生活在哪一个地方，你就生活在这个堕落的世界里面。
A world broken by sin, by evil, by corruption.
这个世界破碎的世界充满了罪恶，充满了一切的诡诈。
Should we be so surprised?
我们会很惊讶吗？
No.
当然不惊讶。
Because it's Satan's world. Satan, who is the God of this world, has blinded the minds of those who don't believe. They are unable to see the glorious light of the good news. They don't understand this message and about the glory of Christ, who is an exact likeness of God.
这人不信之人被这世界的神弄瞎了心眼，不叫基督荣耀福音的光照着他们。基督本是神的像。
People reject Christ because Satan has blinded their eyes.
人今天拒绝耶稣，因为这个世界的神撒旦蒙蔽了他们的眼睛。
Blinded their minds.
他们的心思被蒙蔽了。
They are in total spiritual darkness.
他们在完全属灵的黑暗中。
Their hope is in this world because it provides them what they want.
他们所有的盼望都在这个世界，因为他们在这个世界中又得到他们又所有的一切。
They worship money, fame, fortune, pleasure.
他们在崇拜世界里面的金钱、生命的名声、地位。
Because their identity is identified by these things.
因为他们把自己跟这个世界已经认同了。
Sadly, even Christians fall into Satan's traps.
但是可怜的是，有许多基督徒也落进了撒旦的陷阱里面。
The pull of this world is very real and very strong.
因为这个世界对我们人的吸引是非常大的。
Because it is very attractive.
因为是它对我们的诱惑非常大。
It is attractive because it satisfies the flesh now.
它吸引我们，因为它能够满足我们肉体一切的欲望。
I'm sure you, many of you have seen the advertisements buy now, pay later.
你知道现今很多很多广告都说，你想要的东西先买，然后才付钱。
Why wait when you can have it now?
为什么要等？如果你现在就可以得到呢
？The fear of missing out.
你如果不买，你就会错过。
Instant gratification.
所以他们什么事情都立刻就要。
For Christians, it highlights one important aspect of their spiritual life.
但是据基督徒，我们生活中有属灵的重要的一点。
They lack contentment in their life.
他们能够活出一个知足的心。
They try to fill their life with things and pleasure.
因为不信的人，他们心中乃是又充满了世界一切的享乐。
The problem with them is they do not have eternal value.
是因为他们没有永远的盼望，没有永恒的价值。
Sure, they make you feel good for a while.
虽然世上的东西使你能够一时的快乐，一时的满足。
As Christians, we should seek things of eternal value.
但作为基督徒，我们追求的乃是永恒永远的。
When we do, we don't allow the things of this world to consume us.
我们活着不会让世界这些事情来充满我们。
Do we own things or the things own us?
我们到底是拥有一些事物，还是被这些事物所拥有呢？
Christians should live with the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness.
作为基督徒，我们要活出靠着神的恩典，活出一个感恩的生命来。
Where is the source of this grace?
这恩典的源头出自哪里？
When we know that we have been blessed with every spiritual blessing.
应当我们知道，我们已经从神那里得着一切属灵里面的福气。
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ.
愿颂赞归于我们的主耶稣基督的父神，他在基督里曾赐给我们天上各样属灵的福气。
Brothers and sisters, in today's language, we have it all.
或者照弟兄姐妹按今天世界上的话来讲，我们已经拥有一切了。
He has blessed with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ.
神已经将天上各样属灵的福气都赐给我们。
How gracious of God!
神是何等的恩惠。
And it does not get any better.
而且不会更好。
Having the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness is having contentment in our life.
我们有一颗感恩的心，是因为我们里面有知足的心。
This is the result of having this grace.
有这样的恩典，我们就有这样的结果。
And Paul encourages this way.
而保罗也曾经这样说。
Not that I was ever in need, for I have learned how to be content with whatever I have.
保罗说，我并不是因缺乏说这话，我无论在什么境况都可以知足，这是我已经学会了。
We have contentment because our longing is for eternal things.
我们能够在今世知足，因为我们所盼望的是永远的。
Our longing is for our Lord to fill our hearts with joy in Him.
因为我们所愿意的乃是心中充满着主的喜乐。
Our longing is to be men and women after God's own heart.
我们乃要成为合乎神心意的男人女人。
Our longing is for our Lord's second return in the New Jerusalem.
我们乃是愿意主的再来。
When we have contentment, God will fill us with the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness.
当我们心里面能知足了，神就他的恩典就能够充满我们，给我们一颗感恩的心。
We know that we have been blessed with every spiritual blessing.
因为我们已经知道我们得着了天上各样属灵的福气。
But how do you live out this knowledge?
那怎么样能够把我们所知道的活出来呢
？We know that we've been chosen before the foundations of the world.
因为我们知道，我们是在神创立世界以前就拣选了我们。
But how do we daily rejoice being partakers of the eternal inheritance?
那我们每一天的生活怎样的活出是已经得着永远产业的人呢
？In every spiritual blessing, not material blessing.
是在一切属灵的福气，不是物质上的福气。
So many seek.
但今天世人追求的是物质上的福气。
It's every blessing in the heavenly places.
但我们得着了是天上各样属灵的福气。
His eternal plan chose you, blessed you, and predestined you.
神已经拣选了你，神已经祝福了你，神已经有定义赐给你。
We should be filled with the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness.
我们应该充满着感恩的心。
When you become a Christian, you have a new identity.
当你成为一个基督徒，你就有一个新的地位。
You are no longer defined how the world defines you.
你这新的身份不再是世上的人对你所定的身份。
And no one can take away this identity of yours.
而且没有人能够剥夺你这个新的身份。
Because the living God has secured you in His hand to eternity.
因为永生的神已经非常啊，把你捉在他的手中，没有人能够将你夺去。
That alone is enough to rejoice with thanksgiving and gratefulness.
在这一点上，我们就能够满着感恩和感谢。
You know the best part of having the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness?
我们怎么样能够真正的充满着感恩和感谢呢？
There is no price tag.
真正的价值是没有任何的价钱的。
It is eternal and it is priceless.
因为是永远的，乃是无价的。
Salvation in Christ is free, but it is not cheap.
虽然在基督里的救恩是无价的，但是并不是便宜的。
But please.Don't ever cheapen salvation.
所以愿我们永远不要把救恩看为是廉价的。
It cost our Heavenly Father His one and only Son.
因为真正的价值代价，那是神付上他独生儿子 的生命。
When we know our eternal destination, we should be filled with the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness.
当我们知道我们永远要到哪里去，我们心中就充满着对神的感恩和感谢。
Because God has shifted our values,
因为神帮我们改变我们的价值观
away from this world,
我们的价值观不在世界上
and that our hope lies in the promises that He has made,
而神所给我们的应许也成为我们的盼望
and God keeps all His promises,
而神能够成就他一切的应许
I move to the last grace for this morning,
我现在要讲最后的一点。
The grace to share salvation in Christ.
就使我们能够分享基督福音的恩典。
A few weeks ago, a person I know told me that her mother had suffered a stroke.
在几周之前，我的一个朋友告诉我，她的母亲已经中风了。
One of the first questions I asked her, is your mother saved?
所以我立刻就问她一个问题，说你的母亲得救了吗？
The answer was no.
她说还没有得救。
I then gave her a tract of salvation in Christ to give to my mother.
所以我就给了她一张福音的单张，说你可以带去念给你母亲听。
I told her, your mother needs to know the answer of the most important question in her life.
我告诉她说，你母亲需要知道人生中最重要的一件事情。
Where will she spend eternity?
所以知道的一个答案，就是说她的永远。将会在哪里
？I share salvation in Christ as the Holy Spirit leads me.
圣灵带领我这样跟他分享这个福音。
Because God has given me the grace to share salvation in Christ.
因为神赐给我恩典，能够分享在基督里的福音。
Our Lord will burden you as you see people with no hope.
而主祝我们，使我们能够把盼望带给那些没有盼望的人。
They have no hope because they don't have Christ in them.
他们没有盼望，因为他们没有耶稣。
They have no hope because after this life they will go to hell.
因为他们没有盼望，因为他们结束了今生，只能去地狱。
Hell is real, but they don't know what it is.
地狱是真实存在的，但他们却不知道是怎样的情形。
Until someone tells them.
直到别人告诉他们。
But please don't expect them to receive your news with open arms.
但是你也不要以为他们就是这样的，很容易接受。你所讲传的福音
Because the most difficult doctrine to tell someone is how sinful they are.
因为最能告诉一个人的就是告诉他他是有何等大的罪。
They don't accept that they're sinful before a holy God.
而他们也不愿意承认自己在圣洁的神是一个罪人。
But that should not stop you from sharing the gospel.
但这样的原因不应该阻拦着你去传福音。
Heaven is also real.
因为天堂也是真实的。
And the only way to get there is when you have Jesus living in you.
而唯一能够到天堂去的，就是你里面有耶稣住在你心中。
As Christians, we sow the gospel in season and out of season.
作为一个基督徒，无论得时不得时，我们都传福音。
Many of you may not be familiar with the name Arthur Stace.
我们当中有些人可能对这一个称为阿斯。史泰斯这个人不认识。
But you may remember this picture.
当你们或许有看过这样一张图。
This was in the year 2000.
这是2000年的时候。
Arthur Stace was poor and his parents were alcoholics.
这就阿斯史泰斯这个人，他出生在一个贫穷的家庭，他 的父母都是酗酒的人。
His sisters ran a brothel.
而他自己的姐姐或者妹妹乃是开一个妓院。
He stole to survive.
而他从小就学会偷东西去生活。
He became an alcoholic in his teenage years.
而在他十几岁的时候，他在少年的时候，他就也成了一个酒鬼。
As he grew older, he got into criminal activities.
而等他长大了之后，成年了之后，他就开始犯罪。
In 1932, at age 47, he heard a sermon.
而当他四十七岁的这一年，他忽然听到了一个福音。
It was titled "Echoes of Eternity."
而这个信息的题目乃是永恒的回音。
He spent his last 35 years of his life writing the word "eternity" all over Sydney.
而之后，他把余生的35年就在悉尼这个中心。到处在街上写下“永远”这个词。
Because of this, he was known as Mr. Eternity.
因为他做了这么多，写了这么多，所以人家都称呼他为“永远先生”。
The name above was a wife who died in 1961.
什么
？His wife died in 1961.
他的妻子是在1961年去世的。
The words below are not very clear, but I love the words.
下面的这个墓壁上的字不清楚，但是我喜欢那扇所写的。
It says rewarded and rejoicing in the presence of their Lord.
他说这个人已得着他的赏赐，也在他主的面前享乐。
Brothers and sisters, as God's children, this is our future.
而弟兄姐妹，这作为神的儿女，这也是我们的将来。
It is estimated he wrote the word eternity more than 500,000 times.
人家照案子估计，他这三十五年的时间，在这个街道上写“永远”的这个词，起码写了接近50万。
And Arthur says could not read or write.
但阿瑟史泰斯他是因为没有读书，他是一个文盲。
But God granted him the grace to write this word.
但是神给他的恩典使他学会写这一个词。
Please note the similarity of the way that he wrote the word on chalk and the one on the harbor bridge.
我们看见他是用粉笔在街道上写的这个词，永远这个词的英文词，跟在我们的悉尼大桥上面这个是一样的。
He could not read or write, but the only word that mattered to him was eternity.
他是一个文盲，但是他认识一个词，就是永远。
There were times that he was confronted by police for writing graffiti.
有很多时候，他会在街上写这个词的时候，会得到警察的询问，说你为什么这样在街上涂污。
His answer was always the same. I have permission from above.
他总告诉这个警察说，因为我已经得到从天上来的准许。
He wrote the word eternity without fear or favor.
他写这永远的词，没有一颗害怕的心，妥协的心。
What a testimony!
是何等的见证
！The power of God to transform a person's life.
神的能力改变这个人的一生。
One who truly surrenders to Him.
他信的那一刻，把一生都献给神。
A criminal, an alcoholic, and a shameful past.
一个酒鬼。一个糟糕的过去的历史，还有这样一个犯罪的人，却因福音蒙恩得救。
God chooses people not because of their past.
神不会因着人的过去来为原因来拣选一个人
，but people who they can become.
乃是神拣选一个人，是神能够使他变成怎样一个人。
He is not interested in my or your shameful past.
神对我们的过去一点都不感兴趣。
But he is interested who his son is to you.
他所感兴趣的是你怎样的对待他儿子耶稣。
God chose Arthur Stace before the foundations of the world.
因为神是在创立世界之前就拣选了阿斯史泰斯。
And transformed his life for his purposes and for his glory.
拣选他，拯救他，改变他的一生，为着神自己的旨意。
You don't need to be like Arthur Stace.
你不需要像阿瑟史泰斯这样的过去。
But you need to seek the grace to share salvation in Christ.
但是你又寻求他所得到一样的恩典在基督里。
To have a heart for anyone who has no hope beyond this life.
我们有一颗心，愿意把盼望带给在世界上没有盼望的人。
Because the most important question each person needs to answer.
因为我们每一个人很左右回答一个重要的问题，就是
Where will you spend eternity?
你的永远将会去哪里？
Is it a question that you need to answer this morning?
这个问题也是你今早又回答的吗？
Do you know the answer?
您知道自己的答案在哪里吗？是什么吗？
If you don't know the answer, please speak to someone before you leave.
如果你不知道你的答案是什么，请你在结束之后找人谈一谈。
This morning I've shared about the grace of hope.
今天早上我跟你们分享了盼望的恩典，
the grace to forgive and love，
而使我们能够原谅饶恕的恩典，
the grace of thanksgiving and gratefulness，
使我们能够感谢感恩的恩典，
and the grace to share salvation in Christ，
而使我们能够分享基督福音的恩典。
Everything that we do is by the grace of God，
我们所做的一切都靠神的恩典。
Things that we take for granted，
很多我们都当为平常的事。
Wake up in the morning and do the things that we need to do each day.
好像我们早上醒来，我们 一天又做很多事情。
Brothers and sisters, it is all grace.
但弟兄姐妹，我们所有的一切都是恩典。
Paul says it so well here.
而保罗很好的这样的把它给写出来。
Then the name of Lord Jesus Christ will be honored because of the way you live, and you will be honored along with him. This is all made possible because of the grace of our God and the Lord Jesus Christ.
叫我们主耶稣的名在你们身上得荣耀，你们也在他身上得荣耀，都照着我们的神并主耶稣基督的恩。
God is teaching us that each day to seek him in whatever we need to do.
神在教导我们每一天到他面前寻求恩典，去做我们该做的事情。
And we do it by his grace.
我们能够做成什么是靠他的恩典。
Throughout our whole lives, we are learning how to live out the truth of John 15:5.
我们的一生中都能够所活出的一个真理，乃是约翰福音十五章五节。
I've inscribed the truth in my heart.
我也常常这个真理常常的藏在我的心里面。
I am the vine, you are the branches. The one who remains in me and I in him bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing.
耶稣说：“我是葡萄树，你们是枝子。”藏在我里面的，我也藏在他里面，这人就多结果子，因为离了我，你们就不能做什么。
I can truly say apart from Christ I can do nothing.
我也能够承认说离开了耶稣我什么都做不了。
Apart from Christ I am nothing.
如果没有基督我就什么都不是。
We have been saved by the grace of God.
我们得救是因为神的恩典。
But that is the only beginning.
但这只是我们的开始。
We see the last verse in the book of Revelation.
我们看见启示录末了的一句话。
The grace of the Lord Jesus be with all. Amen.
愿主耶稣的恩惠常与众圣徒同在。阿门。
The verse that I chosen for this morning.
这是我今早所拣选的这节圣经。
I meditated over this verse.
我因这节圣经默想。
I asked, why did the Holy Spirit inspire John to close the book of Revelation with this verse?
我说圣灵为什么感动使徒约翰用这一节圣经来结束整本的圣经呢？
And then I went to look at the opening and closing of all of Paul's epistles.
所以我就去看这个保罗书信的一切的结束结尾。
First and Second Corinthians.
我们看见的是哥林多前书、哥林多后书。
Galatians, Ephesians, and Philippians.
加拉太书、腓立比书。和哥罗西书
Colossians, Thessalonians, Timothy
和帖撒罗尼迦前书或者提摩太前书后书
Titus and Philemon
或者提多书或者腓利门书
Let's share with you just four verses
我先跟你分享四节的圣经
The opening May God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ give you grace and peace May God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ give you grace and peace
在哥林多前书开头的时候说愿恩惠平安从神我们的父并主耶稣基督归你们之后在加拉太书开始的时候也说愿恩惠平安从父神与我们主耶稣基督归你们
And two closing verses. May God's grace be with you. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
而在两节圣经、啊、就是在书信的结尾，在哥罗西书说愿恩惠常与你们同在，而在帖撒罗尼迦前书说愿我主耶稣基督的恩常与你们同在。
It is not surprising to find Paul's constant reference to God's grace.
我们一点也不惊讶保罗常常的提到主耶稣的恩典。
He knew how much he was able to do is because of God's grace.
他知道他自己能做这么多一切都是神的恩典。
Which enabled him to make one conclusion.
所以他能够做这样的一个总结。
But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and His grace towards me did not prove vain. But I labored even more than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God with me.
然我今日成了何等人，是蒙神的恩才成的，并且他所赐我的恩不是徒然的。我比众圣徒格外劳苦，这原不是我，乃是神的恩与我同在。
Everything in our life is by the grace of God.
我们一生中的一切都因为神的恩典。
Everything means everything.
一切就是一切。
That's why Paul could conclude, I am what I am by the grace of God.
所以保罗才能够说，我今日成了何等人，是蒙神的恩典才成的。
In the beginning I asked, why did God give us this free gift of grace?
一开始的时候我问了说，神为什么又把这个恩典白白的赐给我们？
Ultimately, it's for His glory.
最终乃是为着神的荣耀。
We are created to glorify Him.
因为神造我们乃是为着自己的荣耀。
Bring all who claim me as their God, for I have made them for my glory. It was I who created them.
就是凡称为我名下的人，是我为自己的荣耀创造的，是我所做成的，所造作的。
Many people go and find books. What is the meaning of life?
好像很多人写的书说生命的意义是什么。
They want to find the truth and the meaning of life.
他们好像要寻找到人生的意义的答案。
As God's children, we know the purpose in our life.
但作为神的儿女，我们知道我们的人生的意义在哪里。
Our purpose is to glorify God, and He deserves all the glory.
我们人生的意义就是要荣耀神，因为他配得一切的荣耀。
The more we grow in grace, the more we understand the purpose of our life.
我们越在神的恩典中成长，我们就越明白神对我们的意义和旨意。
As we grow in grace, God is conforming us to the image of His Son.
当我们在恩典中成长，神就使我们更像他的儿子耶稣基督。
It is a bottomless well of grace.
神的恩典是没有底的。
It never runs out.
所以也从来都不会流干的。
Until the Lord calls us home.
直到主呼召我们回家。
Which brings me to the reality of the words of John Newton.
所以使我记起的是这个、啊、约翰牛顿曾经说的一句话。
Before his conversion, he was a slave trader.
在他蒙恩得救之前，他是一个贩卖奴隶的人。
To profit from someone's suffering is a terrible trade.
我们知道贩卖奴隶是很痛恶、使人痛恶的事情，因为他们的得意就是在买卖人的生命。
In today's language, we call it the scum of the earth.
我们今天的人就他们是地上的渣滓。
These days, we call this trade human trafficking.
而今天人是这个贩卖人口。
But in God's sovereignty, God saved John Newton.
当神在他的全能的作为拯救了他。
A slave trader saved by the grace of God.
一个贩卖奴隶的奴隶主却蒙恩得救。
And later he went into full-time ministry.
而最终他却全职来侍奉神。
Over the years his faith matured and he was remorseful of what he did.
所以当他成长之后，成长成熟了之后，他对他自己过去所做的一切非常的痛恶。
He wrote the hymn Amazing Grace and I just show you two lines.
他所写的、啊、写的诗歌就是奇异的恩典，我跟你们分享两节。
This grace, can we have a cloth, please? Just leave it there. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
This grace has brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. Sorry, I do not know the name.
Yeah, we're just trying to find it.
Does anyone know him number?
187首.
Sorry.
187首.
This grace has brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home.
第4节.
Later, John Newton was involved in abolishing slavery.
所以之后，这个约翰牛顿他是也发起了这解放奴隶的这个运动。
And he testified against slavery in Parliament.
而且在他们的议会里面出来做见证。
And
拒绝这个奴隶制。
And slavery was abolished 9 months after he died.
所以在他去世9个月之后，这个贩卖奴隶的这个就被禁止了。
Grace brought John Newton thus far.
所以是恩典把牛顿约翰领回天家。
And grace took him home.
带领了他跋涉长途，也平安地领他回天家。
Brothers and sisters, by God's grace, we are on the same journey.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，靠神的恩典，我们也在跋涉长途。
Each day, God's grace takes us from what we need to do each day.
每一天，神给我们足够的恩典，能够来引领我们这一天。
And one day, grace will take us home.
有一天，神的恩典也将我们领回天家。
John Newton's story is a good reminder to us all.
约翰牛顿的故事是对我们一个很好的提醒。
It's not how we start, it's how we finish for the glory of God.
不是我们怎样的开始，重要的是我们怎样的结束。
I can't think of a better future.
我不能够想象我们还有一个更好的将来。
To think of being rewarded and rejoicing in the presence of our Lord.
就让我们能够蒙祝福而享受在神的面前。
This future is for believers only.
而这样的将来是唯一给信耶稣的人。
For non-believers, it doesn't matter how well you start or how well you finish.
但是一个不信耶稣的人是不在乎你开始的多好，结束的多好。
No amount of good works will earn your place in heaven.
因为无论你行了多少的善事，都不足够你去天堂。
Nothing will save you from the coming judgment.
没有任何的善事能够拯救你又面对的审判。
You know the problem with people who teach salvation by works?
你知道那些教导别人说是行善来躲避审判的那些人吗？
Ask them one question.
你只要问他们这样一个问题。
How much good works must I do to buy myself out of hell?
就问他们，我又行多少的善事才足够我上天堂？
How much money must I donate to charities?
我又捐款多少钱才能够上天堂？
How many people do I need to help?
我又帮助多少人之后，我才能够上天堂？
How many prayers must I say each day?
我每一天又多少的祷告才能够上天堂？
Unbelievers will face the coming judgment because you have no hope.
不信耶稣的人，他们又面对永远的审判，他们没有盼望。
When coming judgment comes, there will be no escape.
当审判临到，没有人可以逃避。
Your hope can only be found in Christ.
你一切的盼望只能在基督里找到。
I started this morning sharing a tragic story.
我开始的时候讲了一件悲伤的事情。
But it's a story with hope because of Christ.
但那个所讲的有盼望，因为他们有耶稣。
The parents hope to see the 21-month-old child again.
他这个父母盼望有一天会再看见他们21个月的孩子。
The death of any unbeliever is not only death.
但是不信耶稣的人。 不只是死了就没事了。
It's death without hope.
他们是在没有盼望中死去。
It's death and spending eternity in hell.
他们死了之后会永远地落在地狱里。
If you are not saved, this is your future.
如果你没有蒙恩得救，这就是你的将来。
If you'd like to live with the hope of eternal life, please speak to someone before you leave today.
你如果有得着永远的生命和盼望，那你结束之后可以跟 信徒谈一谈。
Let us pray.
让我们现在祷告。
Our gracious Heavenly Father, Lord.
我们慈悲仁爱的天父，我们的主。
As Christians, we give you thanks for hope, Lord.
作为基督徒，我们又感谢、赞美归给你，你赐给了我们盼望。
Because your Son is our hope.
你的儿子就是我们的盼望。
And he's a living savior because you resurrected him.
他是一个复活的主，因为他从死里复活。
And you have promised to return, Lord Jesus.
主啊，你也应许你又再来。
Thank you for this wonderful hope.
感谢你赐给我们这样活泼的盼望。
For anyone who has no hope in here this morning, please speak to them.
主啊，在我们当中还没有盼望的人，求你对他们的心说话。
Stir their hearts.
感动他们的心。
Give them no peace until they make their peace with you.
使他们心中没有平安，直到他们在到你这里来找到平安。
In Jesus' name we pray.
祷告奉主耶稣的名。
Amen. Amen. Brothers and sisters, if I can ask you to spare me a few minutes, I just want to do a brief sharing of what just happened to me 2 days ago.
所以在这个结束之前，我想又借用你们五分钟的时间，跟弟兄姐妹分享最近发生在我身上的事情。
I want to thank every one of you who has prayed for me and my family and the shop.
我也感谢你们当中所有为我祷告，也为我家庭祷告，而且为我的公司祷告的人。
I am overwhelmed by the prayers, by the support, and by your care and love.
我实在是很感激你们所给我的支持和祷告。
I am overwhelmed by the support that I receive from all sources, people I have never met or total strangers.
我也很感激我从那些从未碰面过认识的人所给我的支持。
It is a reminder I'm not home yet.
这里只是对我一个提醒，我还没有归天家。
It's also a reminder this issue is not about me.
而且也提醒我，所以我经历的不是关乎我自己一个人的事。
It's about our sovereign God, the Almighty God.
是我们公义的神，我们全能的神。
And it's about salvation in Christ.
也是关乎在基督里的拯救。
In my devotion on this morning, I'm reminded of Genesis 50:20.
在我今早这个读经的时候，我读到了创世纪。
When Joseph said, "You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good."
当约瑟对他的兄弟说，你们以为这一切是为着恶的，但是神却使它变得美好。
I do pray that good will come out of this.
我的祷告就是我经历的这一切最终的结局是好的。
I'm also deeply humble.
而且经历这件事使我很深深的谦卑下来。
But God would use a nobody like me for His purposes.
说神既能使用我这样一个微小的人来成就他的旨意。
But I thank you for your prayer support and for your love.
但我很感谢你们为我的祷告和支持。
Pray for those who are against the gospel.
我们也要为那些反对福音的人祷告。
That by God's grace they will come to receive Christ.
而靠神的恩典，他们有一天也会接受耶稣。
Thank you.
谢谢。
Sorry about that.
That's okay.
Thank the Lord's message this morning.
感谢神的话语今天早上。
And we thank the brother Wing to share with us.
谢谢温弟兄的分享。
And we can reflect that it's by the grace of our Lord that we are all here today.
我们能看到的是，就是因为神的恩典，我们全都在这里。
And I wouldn't go ponder into what has been spoken this morning.
我要回想起今天早上在说的话。
And I think there are a few key points that we need to take note.
有几个非常重要的，我们需要铭记。
And just not try to repeat what the Wing has shared with us.
对，我不重复温弟兄所分享的话语。
Everything is by the grace of the Lord that we are able through Christ Jesus. So He has given us this wonderful salvation.
这样，崇高的救恩是来自于我们的主耶稣。
And is that we are able to be here to be in the built up in the body of Christ?
我们在这里，我们若不是在基督的身体里，我们不可以在这里。
And let's reflect now the when I hearing this hymn, the song just now that we share a little bit on the message, Amazing Grace.
我在
这中，by John Newton.
我们再听一下刚刚的这个谢尔的诗歌，奇妙的救恩。
But I would like to share with you a hymn that can we just May we sing this hymn together?
同样，我有首诗歌和大家一起分享。
And reflect upon the message this morning.
和早上的话语有所呼召。
Or when we give thanks to the Lord for.
我们将感谢赞美献给我们的主。
And this is from the small hymn book 73.
小本诗歌第七十二首。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢耶稣。
For Jesus that is here, that God has given us, that by His grace that we are all saved.
因着神的恩典，我们在他里面，我们都蒙蒙得救。
And for those who are here that join us this morning,
所有的人都在这里和我们一起参加的。
And if you have not received the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior,
如果你还没有受到主为是你的救主，我们为你祷告。
And I'd like you to also think about it.
七十二首。
72. Can we sing it this way? Maybe the first time when we sing this hymn, I ask those who can sing in English to sing once, and then we'll sing second time in Chinese, and then we can sing all together.
我们第一遍的时候用英文唱，第二遍的时候用中文，啊，三遍唱的时候我们一起。
And give our heart to Him this morning that we can give thanks to our.
把我们的心交给我们的主。
Thank you, Jesus, for your love to me. Thank you, Jesus, for your grace so free. I lift my voice to praise your name. Praise you again and again.
谢主。
And firstly, we'd like to welcome a friend here this morning.
我们首先我要感谢今天第一次来的弟兄。
And we'd like to welcome you. And there is one here, 秀永进。
我们欢迎季弟兄，季永进弟兄。
Can we check? Welcome you.
我们感谢，我们欢迎你。
Is there anyone here that you have not?You're here the first time.
还有第一次来的弟兄没有登记的吗？
来的要 welcome you.
我们需要欢迎你。
Okay, if not, then after this, we ask you to join us for lunch and you can have.
我邀请你和我们一起用午餐，在后面的会堂。
Okay, and also, yes, I hope you all can read.
我们有一个失误认领的通知。第一个是一个黑色的包，是上周留下的。第二个 是一副眼镜，已经在这里好几周了。黑色的包在后面。
You can collect and someone has left some glasses. I hope you can read without a pair of glasses. Okay, and okay, we thank the Lord for this morning's gathering and the message, and let's have time together. And we thank that you all can come and join us for lunch, and we can have a fellowship together.
好的，我们再次的感谢主今天早上的分享 和话语，我们接下来一起的用餐。
Let's give thanks.
让我们一起感谢神。
Heavenly Father, we do give thanks to you for your grace and mercy each time.
慈爱的天父，我们每次来到你的施恩宝座面前，感谢你的救恩和恩典。
And by your grace that you've given salvation in our Lord Jesus.
因着你的恩典，你将救恩 给了我们的主耶稣基督。
And that we have this eternal hope.
只是我们有了这永生的盼望。
Thank you, Lord.
感谢主。
And today, Lord, as we come together, we have this time of time together to hear your words.
谢谢你，亲爱的主，给我们这样一起的时间来听你的话语。
May your words be the lamp of our feet.
因为你的话语是让我们
lamp of our feet.
这是我们脚前的，让你的话语成我们脚前的灯。
And Lord, that we will be able to walk in the light of this world.
使我们可以跟着你的光进入到你的国。
And Lord, we thank you for this challenging time that we are facing.
谢谢你让我们有这样挑战的时间让我们面对。
And you are giving us a good time to understand, Lord, that your coming is near.
你给我们好的时间让我们知道你会再来。
And we need to really hold on to the grace that you have given us.
我们一定要坚定自己的信仰和你的救恩。
That we can be able to alert ourselves.
使我们可以常常的警示我们自己。
Continue to hold on to you.
让我们永远的靠住你。
By your grace that we can all be all built up in the body of Christ.
因着你的恩典，我们自己可以让主耶稣基督来塑造我们。
And Lord, that we also pray for the time that the ministry that you've given us all in Roseville.
我们也亲爱的主，我们也感谢你在祝福我们教会的事工。
We thank you for every brother and sisters.
谢谢每位弟兄和姐妹。
That we are able to come together to serve you.
让我们可以一起来到你的面前侍奉你。
And to also enjoy your grace.
然后去享受你的恩典。
We ask for the blessing of the hands that prepare the meals for us this afternoon.
我们也感谢你为我们预备的食物和厨房侍奉的弟兄姐妹。
May you bless the time of us together.
请你祝福我们的时间，让我们一起的交通时间。
And in the fellowship of your love, that we can be able to hold on to each other.
会在我们一起服侍的弟兄间的爱，我们可以更加的彼此相爱。
And we give you thanks.
我们感谢。
We pray all this in the precious name of our Lord Jesus.
我们这样的祷告，奉靠我主耶稣最宝贵的名，阿门。
Thank you, brother.